Hi. Today we are going to see local peering gateway. In this, I'm going to show a scenario where the peering will be done in the same region and same tenant. But what is local peering gateway? The local peering gateway is used to connect two VCN residing in the same region. The advantage of local peering the connectivity is done between a private network and it doesn't need to go via internet connectivity. That's the main advantage. And the VCN within the same region can be peered using local peering gateway. And the VCN can reside in the same tenancy or it can be in a different tenancy. But the region should be same. There are few limitations, like the VCN cannot be in different region. For that, we need to use remote peering. And before we do this peering, there should not be any overlapping for the CIDRs between the VCN. So I'm going to show two different scenarios, but in this session, the scenario what we are going to see is connectivity between same region and the same tenant, the connectivity of VCN, which would be in the same region and same tenant. This picture shows you clear a whole idea of how it's going to connect. So we have a company A tenancy and it has two VCN, VCN A and VCN B. And the connectivity goes via the DRC. And once before we establish connection, we need to update the route table of each VCN to make the connectivity. So these are the high level steps which I'm going to discuss before I'm going to the demo. First, we gather the information of VCN IP CIDR between two VCNs which need to be established. And we create a VCN LPG, local peering gateway in VCN A, and we create a VCN LPG in VCN B, and validate both VCN is attached to the DRC. Next, we will establish the peering connection for VCN A. And sixth step, we will add the route table entry and secure list in requester VCN, and similarly add the route entry in the acceptor VCN. Finally, we will, once the peering is done, then we can test the ping between the servers residing in both VCN. So these are some reference notes for you. So let's go to the practical. So I've already created two VCN. You can see VCN A and VCN B. As shown in the diagram, this is the CIDR block of VCN A and this is the CIDR block of VCN B. And both resides in the Ashburn region and same tenancy. Now we need to do an established connection between these two VCN via local peering gateway. So let's go to the VCN A. So VCN A and VCN B, we have two. So let's first create a local peering gateway from the VCN A. So go to the VCN A, scroll down, you will see local peering gateway, click that, click create and name it whatever name appropriate. I'm going to give VCN A LPG local peering gateway. Click create and you can see new, not connected to a peer. So let's go to B VCN. Similarly, you click the local pairing and click create local pairing. Here I'm going to say BCN B G. Right. Now let's go back to the BCN A and click the three dots and click establish pairing connection. Now, before you do this, we need to go and make sure we have added these two VCN to the TRG. So I'm going to go to network, TRG, TRG1, and you can see I've added it. VCN A, VCN. So this need to be added before we establish. Now let's go to VCN A, three dots, establish pairing connection. Now select the correct compartment and which is the virtual card VCN. You are going to establish connection with VCN B and you need to create the local pairing gateway in VCNB. Now when you click hit establish, it will take few minutes to pair. Now you can see the status is paired in VCNA. Let's go to VCNB and if you refresh, you can see the paired connection. And the paired IP CIDR is 192.60, which is the CIDR block of VCN A. And when we go to VCN A, and you can see peering status paired, and the CIDR is VCN B CIDR block. And this is not a cross tenancy, you can see now. So now all you need to add the route on each VCN and the security list to communicate between the both servers in this VCN. So let me go to the route table, default route. And here I need to add .16.16. This is the CIDR for VCN. Similarly, go to VCN A. And add a CIDR of VCNB. This is the CIDR of VCNA 168.192.168/16. Yes, that's the CIDR. Now click add. Now let's go and add it in the security list. So it seems I have already added. You can see here I have added all protocols. Similarly, I'll go to DCNA routable, sorry, security list. So that's all we need to establish the connection between two VCM. Thank you.